but it's a good place sometimes to bring kids who need moral structure. Trying to drive here. Holy! That is fairly inconsiderate of you, sir, son. Son, sir. I say. Say it isn't so. Silage. I say, sir, son, can you see the silage? It is there, so I say. So I said. So I did! Apologize. That's a good place to park a tractor, bud. Consider those aren't very reflecting. At night, and you're about an inch and a half off the road surface, yeah, it's a little bit dangerous, probably. Some jackass like Muttonchop comes rolling through here nightwards with shitty headlights and a 21-year-old vehicle. Slam down! Thank you, ma'am! If by the end of this coming summer, they don't have this fucking yard filled up, you know, with some sort of fucking, how you doing, and it's just sitting in an open field, I'm gonna have to go offer my services. I'm gonna have to go to Home Depot, spend about 25 bucks minimum. Bring a couple 4x4s over there, get them some flower poles going, build them a couple fucking, bring in some fucking 6x's and build them some beds up. I'm gonna have to, because that just looks too fucking ridiculous with a giant house in the middle of the field. How you doing? How you doing? Oh, that's new. I don't remember seeing that fucking barn slash garage behind it last time. Maybe I'm just not observant. I hardly ever go down this road anymore since I gave church up. I mean, I'm never a big fan of the church in general per se anyway. I mean, I got nothing against them. My spirituality does not reside in a church, so a church I do not need to go to find it. But it's a good place sometimes to bring kids who need moral structure, you know, if nothing else, to force them to fucking sit still for 45 minutes and listen. So we went for a while. Nonetheless, the point was, gays aren't going to heaven and gays aren't allowed in the church, and if you're gay, you're wrong and it's a choice. I don't know, whatever. So I just like, okay, well, we're not going back there. We're done. Like, you just basically proved you're not a Christian, so no need to come to this place anymore. Clearly, me not being a churchgoer or calling himself a Christian at all is more of a Christian than you, since I know that everybody's equal, period. You know, I mean, you might be a shitbag, you know, and you might be a hateful, you know, whatever. So you're definitely a piece of shit all the way, but you still have equal rights. Like, you're still fucking, you are just as fucking free to be a shitbag as somebody else is to be gay, you know? Because we live in America, and I don't buy into the fact that, you know, whatever, if there is a God or whatever, like, really? You're telling me that fucking God's making people away, you know, he's making people, and so he's making people gay, and then he doesn't like gay people. Well, that's just stupid. Derp, here's your sign, derp. All right, gotta get some gurgle for the old lady. Gurgle. Fucking lights on, stupid fuck. Jesus Christ. I was about to get his ass if he pulled in the parking lot. Turn your lights on, you stupid fucking cocksuck motherfucking piece of shit. Do you see how every fucking car has their lights on and you don't? You stupid motherfucker. Jesus fucking Christ. So clearly they're not contributing to the evolution of the species. They're contributing to the fucking degression of it. Regression of it. Degression is probably not a word. Wow, I didn't see that fuck twat at all. I mean, I did, obviously, because I backed up. And I probably still had time. But I think what I'm actually really pissed at is the store I just went to. This lady's a bitch. I mean, every time I go in there, which granted is few and far between, but I'm just as nice as I can fucking be. Hey, how are you? Staying warm, blah, blah, blah. Just courteous and fucking like I always goddamn am. You know, until you start being a shit fuck. And she is always a shit fuck. So she proceeds to tell, oh, please, she didn't say please, oh, don't set those cans down so hard. Oh, really, I'm just setting them down so fucking hard. I'm just throwing them against the, I'm setting him on the counter like a normal fucking person was. Not fucking hard, not fucking soft, just normal, regular. How you doing? Pick it up, set it down. I was like, oh, what's the matter? You got a headache? I'm sorry. Oh, I got a cold. Oh, that's worse. I apologize. But then, like, why the fuck are you at work in a customer service position if you got a cold? Now, I understand why. Probably because you got bills to pay. But maybe don't tell people you got a cold. I don't know. Maybe do. I don't know. I'm pissed because now I think I'm going to get sick. And I'm not good sick. So I'm trying not to fucking touch anything until I get to the house so I can fucking Lysol all these fucking beers and Lysol my keys and Lysol all the money that I put in that bag and wash my hands and come Lysol my fucking car from all the spots I fucking touched because this bitch is about to get me sick. Like, you need a fucking face mask, cunt, and some fucking gloves. Like, how stupid are you? Y'all all quit, man, for this video. It's fine. But I'm still putting it up. I can't stand ignorant, rude, discourteous motherfuckers that think the world's all about them. Oh, I'm sick at a customer service mission where I'm going to interact with literally hundreds of people today. Let me not take any precautions to not get all of them sick. Like, that's how epidemics start, you silly bitch. Jesus fucking Christ. If I have to work and I'm sick, I wear a mask. And when I worked in customer service positions and food positions, I fucking called out. I mean, Jesus Christ, I've been broke my whole fucking life, so that she ain't no more broke than I am, and I've called out plenty of times. Oh, okay, I guess if I don't eat for 2 days, then I don't eat for 2 days. But at least I'm not gonna get everybody goddamn I fucking encounter sick. Like, what the fuck, man? Just a little bit of common decency is all we're asking, people. If I was wealthy, I'm not sure I'd ever leave the house. If I was wealthy, I'd probably live in a fucking compound and have a fucking assistant who went and did all my shit. Go do my shopping. Don't take my car to the shop. Like, I don't know why I'd have a car if I'm living in a compound, but I guess to drive around the compound. But yeah, I'd totally probably be a fucking hermit, so I wouldn't ever have to go out and deal with people again. Because there's just too many fucked up assholes out there. Without a bigger backlog of content, I could probably avoid putting this video up. So I'm not seen as such a hateful, cocksucking son of a bitch. But you know what? Sometimes I am a hateful, cocksucking son of a bitch. Sometimes I don't give a fuck. Sometimes people push me past the fucking edge, and I'm gonna goddamn let people know. Or at least I'm gonna let somebody know. Look at it this way. Y'all are saving my wife a ton of grief, because she used to hear all this shit, and now y'all do. Y'all like, thanks a lot, Muttonchop, you fucking ass. Wow. Maybe just fucking turn off the camera and drive around and pretend like it's on and bitch like a fucking loon. And then when you're done, then turn the camera back on and save both your wife and us. How about that for courteousness, you fucking son of a bitch? It's a good point you've all made here. That's a good point. And thusly, I will put up this video so that you all see that I'm taking heed of your lesson. Oh, there's my pool balls. Did y'all ever even something before that I told you about? That's, I don't even know why the fuck, but I did. Like years and years ago, because I'm a fucking goof. So don't know why I did, but I did. And so yeah, lesson, I won't say lesson learned, but lesson certainly taken into account. And I will certainly try in the future to not be such a fucking reactive dickhead. I apologize. Go get a cold.